Hey yo, it is me, Swarple, and welcome to my first ever tutorial. Yay! I'm excited for this, I'm hoping this will help any aspiring artists out there in my audience. Hello to you guys, by the way. I would love to talk to you guys and help you out if you need it, so yeah, comment or even shoot me a DM on Instagram. This is about character shapes. This topic has been covered many times on YouTube, but I feel like I have important things to add. I don't want to go on too long talking about what people have already said, but basically a character shape can tell you a lot about them and their personalities. Examples: soft and round means friendly, square and angular means strong and intimidating, upside down triangle means cunning villain. That's been talked about a lot. But even though I knew it for a long time, I really struggled with it, so I want to talk about it because I understand it a lot better now, and because how I do it isn't really something that I see in videos or even learned really in school. So when I was struggling with this, a professor talked to me about it, and he showed me this artist named Sean Galloway. The dude's work is really cool. What my professor explained is that Galloway creates a lot of characters' torsos as two triangles connected. Now, this is not a replacement for learning about human anatomy. Please learn anatomy. It is important, even if your art style is cartoony, especially if it's cartoony, because you need to know the rules before you can properly break them. So what this method does is simplify what are essentially the ribcage and pelvis as triangles, focusing on the character's overall shape rather than the details of their bones and muscles. So I want to talk about how to do this in a way that will give characters unique shape language and body types, and then about posing characters using this method. I'm going to use two different characters for this first part because they have different body types, and I think it's a good demonstration of the variety that just two triangles can give you. These are characters from a horror comic I'm currently doing concept work for, called Dark Matters. I might make a separate short video to explain the premise if you guys are interested, but none of that here. This is a tutorial. This is the main character, named April, and this is... I'll call him Edward. So, like I said, these two have different body types. Not only is one female and the other male, meaning they are already going to have some differences in bone structure, but April is very pear-shaped in terms of body type. She has a little bit of a bigger waist and is rounder. Edward looks kinda skinny and dorky with his overall triangle shape. People don't talk about this one, but I feel like a long triangle really works for nervous or awkward characters, usually teenagers, although Edward here is an exception. These two are both made of two triangles. The difference here is the size and dimensions of said triangles. They're not like the example here. April's lower triangle is wider and more like an equilateral triangle than Edward's. Both of Edward's are thinner and his top triangle is a lot longer. That said, even though his overall shape is a triangle, you'll still see the top triangle is upside down. This is because Edward's skeleton, like everyone else's, has shoulder blades, which his arms are connected to. We don't want to remove that. So basically what this method does is be like, okay, here's where the ribcage would be, here's where the pelvis would be, but we're going to draw them as shapes that we can manipulate to make different body types. So now we're going to draw April in a more interesting pose. Character posing is also something that's talked about a lot on YouTube and on the internet in general. There are lots of videos on it, but I think showing how you can pose with these triangle shapes could help a lot of people. Again, really quickly, I'll talk about what's been talked about in other videos, which is action line. Here are some poses I've done with these two characters already. So basically, an action line is a line drawn down the center of the character's head and all the way down through their feet. Unlike the first drawings I showed where they're just standing, you want your action lines to be very curved but still easy to read. Even if they're just standing, you want a slight curve to their pose. The more of a curve there is, the more dynamic it is. The less of a curve, the more static it is. You want to draw dynamic poses most of the time, especially with action poses like running, jumping, swinging a weapon, etc. In the best ones, the legs also flow into the action line. If the character isn't human and has things like a tail or really long ears, you can try drawing those so that they also flow with the action line. So when I start a pose, I think about what I want to draw and throw in a rough action line. In this case, I used reference because reference is really good. Use reference whenever you can, it will really improve your art. I got this photo off Senshi Stock, a really good DeviantArt page that's got tons of photos of people posing just for reference. I'll put a link down in the description. Anyway, I then quickly sketch in a generic head shape and then the triangles, which I try to keep a little bit more accurate to the specific character design. That said, I'm not trying to be super accurate, this just helps me visualize what I'm trying to draw before I'm really trying to draw it. Then I add little sticks for the arms and legs. Note that when I do it for the legs, I put the little circles for the top of the legs on the sides of the triangle rather than below. This is because, quick anatomy lesson, the pelvis is shaped like this, kind of like a bowl to hold our guts in. And the sockets for our femurs are on the sides of the pelvis, not the bottom. Knowing this helped me a lot. My characters didn't really look like they had butts until I learned about that. That might not seem like a big deal, but people noticed that it looked odd. Also notice that as I draw, I'm not copying the pose exactly. The action line in the photo is pretty static, and I don't want that in my drawing, so I repositioned April's legs to have a curve to them. Human legs are actually pretty curvy, not straight, so you can get away with things like this. Once I have the pose here, I pull up a new layer and do the actual sketch on top. Since I know human anatomy and the proportions of these characters, I can pretty easily correct the proportions here. When I connect the triangles with the actual shape of the torso, I connect the circle representing the top of the humerus to the circle representing the top of the femur. With female characters like April, the line is more curved. And that's all I have to do for the torso, connect the triangles. I didn't have to go in and draw the anatomy underneath, and this helped me to keep her body type consistent. It's not entirely perfect, but the triangles worked just as they should have. It's the legs that could use some adjustments here. But I honestly don't know how I'd pose so quickly if I didn't have the triangle method. It saves me a lot of time and it helps give my characters unique shapes, even when they're supposed to look like pretty normal people as opposed to really exaggerated. I hope this helped you or gave you a new perspective. If you liked it, then hit the like button. If you have any questions or anything you're curious to see a tutorial on, let me know in the comments. And again, if you're a fellow artist who wants to talk, by all means, comment or shoot me a message. Talking to artists is wonderful. I miss school where everyone was an art nerd. Thanks so much for watching this. I hope you liked it and that you have a great day. I will see you all in the next video. Goodbye.